What is going on, everybody? If you're new here, welcome. My name is Reggie Bryant, and this channel is all about personal finance and personal growth, where I show you how to save money and make more money, all while making yourself better every single day. I've got a special video for you today. So I just hit 5,000 subscribers, and that's another huge milestone for me. And I just want to say thank you for supporting this channel and watching my videos. It really does mean a lot. It seriously is a great feeling to add value to people from all over the world. So today, instead of me sharing my financial tips and advice, I'm gonna share some advice from my viewers, and they actually give some really dope advice, and it's stuff that I haven't thought of myself. Like, I learned a lot just by looking at what my viewers had to say, and I took some notes, and I'm actually gonna apply some of these to my life. So throughout me making videos, I've received a ton of feedback from viewers, subscribers, everybody, and most of it was through comments. So when I got to 5,000 subscribers, I reached out to my audience directly through the community tab. I was like, hey, hit me up, give me your best money saving hacks. And I gave everyone a bunch of different ways to contact me. So obviously there's commenting on YouTube. I had a few on the community tab. I also had some emails and DMs. So I'm super excited to go over this. Let's dive right in. And just so you know, I don't have the best memory in the world, so I'm definitely gonna be looking down. So first up, we've got Sade. She emailed me. And first of all, I just want you to take a look at my screen right here that I'm looking at. And I just wanna appreciate how long this email is, because she really put some detail and some thought into this. So check this out, man. I mean, just an amazing email. The fact that she put that much time into it, we're about to go over all of these. So these are actually really dope. So the first one is, if you work outside of your place of residence, try to live as close to your job as possible. And you know, this is something I think a lot of people miss out on, because I actually used to do this myself. I lived a whopping 2 minutes away from my last job, and it saved me all kinds of money on gas. But I want to get into her specific reasoning. So she said, I mainly did this out of convenience, but it just so happened to save me quite a bit of money. This will enable you to save a lot of money on car maintenance, oil changes, tires. That is facts. Because right now what I'm doing is I'm traveling 30 minutes to work, 30 minutes from work. So it's an hour total to and from work, and my tires are gonna wear a lot faster. I'm gonna have to do a lot more oil changes on my car than she would. You know what I mean? I'm gonna have to get gas way more often, and I'm gonna spend way more on all of these things than she will, just because of the fact that she doesn't get on the road as much. And that is a very good way to save money. And she goes on to say, not to mention all the time you save in traffic as well. When I started my current job in 2019, I had an hour commute. A month and a half later, I moved into an apartment, which is about 2 miles away from the place that she works at now. And she's genuinely surprised at the fact that she doesn't have to go to the gas station all the time. She doesn't have to get her oil changed all the time. It's not frequent at all like it used to be. And the key thing she says is, you know, after saving money on car maintenance, oil changes, tires, and gas, stuff like that, she said that she can put more money towards the thing that she really cares about. And I think that's a big key. Anytime you're talking about money, saving money, the point is putting your money towards something that you really care about. Now, the second one we got, this is also from Sade. By the way, she has three total, so we're gonna go over all of them. The second one is, YouTube is my TV. And this is a really dope one. This is something that kind of blew my mind a little bit. So Sade says, I don't own a TV, nor do I have any streaming services such as Netflix or Hulu. And she got me beat there, because I got Netflix and Hulu, you know what I'm saying? But I feel what Sade is saying. She said, instead of watching reality TV shows, I watch blogs and podcasts from my favorite creatives and bloggers such as Belief in Fatherhood, Halise, Evelyn from the Internets, Katia Lamore, I hope I'm saying that name right, and Octavia Steen. I don't see my name up there low key, but I feel what you're saying. I feel what you're saying, Sade. It actually makes a lot of sense. So she said, just to name, and that's just to name a few. So maybe I was in there. Who knows? But the point is, that suffices for her. And she says, this is more realistic to me than reality TV shows. And that is a fact. Reality TV shows are scripted. They're made to produce as much drama as possible for entertainment value. Having real people on YouTube vlogging their lives, that's more of a realistic way of understanding how a person's life is. And she said when she's not watching those things, she's listening to spiritually uplifting content, business-related content, and documentaries. And I think that's a very productive way to use your time, instead of just watching random stuff, mindless stuff, just chilling. You're actually using content to add value to your life besides entertainment. This is actually stuff that you could apply and be uplifted by and have that positivity in your life. And I think that's really cool. Keep in mind, y'all, YouTube is free. So she said that she never runs out of content, because the people that she watches, like me, for example, upload pretty regularly. And so knowing that, she already knows when to expect them to upload. So she already has something to look forward to. And check this out. I think it's really cool that she actually shared this with me, because this kind of put specifics behind what I was just saying. She said that her entertainment consists of stuff like parenting techniques, household management skills, and business management. And I think that's really cool to actually highlight in this email, because these things are productive skills to actually learn. Like, I mean, having a habit of learning those parental skills, when you become a parent, you're going to be that much better, just because you're getting that initial traction with just your habit of looking and learning about these things. I think that's really cool. And Sade, if I'm saying anything wrong or if I misinterpreted something, you email me, just let me know in the comments. And this one right here is actually really cool. I've never heard of this one before. Shop your store. And apparently this is compared to a point that I make in one of my videos titled I Eat for Free. If you haven't seen that, go ahead and check it out. So what Sade is doing here is incredible. It's very, very, very smart. And I never would have thought of this. And she actually sent me some pictures to share with you so I can bring this point home. So it's when you take something that you would normally splurge on. You know, in my videos, I always talk about shoes, video games, whatever your vice is. You know, for her, it's hair care products. In this email, she talks about how she spent a lot of time watching a ton of videos over the last like decade on just hair care products alone. And I guess one day she was watching a video and they talked about Black Friday, which she hadn't participated in until literally last year. So she waited until Black Friday and went and bought about a year's worth of hair care products. And the genius behind this is, instead of splurging throughout the year, instead of getting emails from JCPenney, Macy's, or wherever else has these types of products, where it might be, you know, 10% off, 15% off. She waits till Black Friday when these things are 30 to 60% off. We're talking about, you know, bottles worth of, say, $12 to $30 cut in literally like half. So she gets the best of both worlds. She saves money and she gets the very thing that she used to splurge on. And then the emails that she subscribed to that talk about these sales going on, she unsubscribes. She deletes the emails because she's like, what do I need to do that for? I can just wait until the same time every single year, Black Friday, to go ahead and get these. And that's smart because it's predictable. Black Friday is going to happen every single year and things are going to be on sale every single year. And of course, she takes it a step further. I mean, let me show you these pictures right here, bro. Let me show you these pictures. This is cold. I don't care what nobody says. She makes it into her own little store. Like, look at this. It's even stocked up like a store would. And I used to be a stocker at a grocery store back in the day, so I know. Look, these are some gems right here. Y'all better take notes. So instead of doing all this running around shopping throughout the year, you create your own store at the lowest, cheapest price possible. And obviously all these things have shelf lives. So I'm not as knowledgeable as she is, but I know for a fact it's between like 6 and 12 months. And so what she does is she has a planner to schedule her use of these products. Sade is cold, man. Y'all give her a round of applause, man. She knows what she's doing, man. By the way, every person that's up here on this video, we're gonna give them a round of applause because they deserve it. And you know, as I go through everybody's examples and advice throughout this video, I want y'all to comment and let me know what y'all think and even comment your own advice. So next up we have Lynn, and I'm going to go straight into my Instagram DMs for this because she DM'd me and it's really awesome stuff that she gave us. So first off, she shows some love and I appreciate that, Lynn. And then she gets into the advice right then and there. And these are rules that she lives by. So first, Lynn says to read and never stop learning about your personal finances. And I cannot stress that enough. That is huge. And that's something I don't think a lot of people do. So whenever you're wanting to improve with anything, especially finances, think of more than just surface level stuff. This is more than just reading a book. This is more than just watching a video, more than just listening to a podcast. Because based off of other people's takes and perspectives, that's how you're gonna understand what financial advice form fits to you as opposed to someone else's advice. So you could agree with personal finance advice that you read in a book, and then you can watch my video, one of my videos on my channel. You can disagree with what I say because the person's take on it, the person's perspective on whatever topic it is, it might fit specifically to your life and it might actually work for you. Except my advice could be just as valuable as that advice in the book, but what matches you? And that's why I think it's so important to follow Lynn's advice here, which is really good advice, to continuously learn about finances. And then you'll find that as your life goes on, some advice that applied to you earlier on may not apply to you anymore. So now you need to step your game up and understand a different perspective and learn even more information about it. Now, this advice here got my attention. Lynn says, if you want to buy something, wait a few weeks, because then you may not even want it as much as you thought you did. You're not necessarily saying no to yourself. You're just saying no, not right now. And that really resonates with me. It actually reminds me of a book called I Will Teach You to Be Rich, but it's basically just delaying your gratification. So I talk about Nike all the time. I'm wearing a Nike shirt right now. So in my case, if I'm at a Nike store and I see some shoes that I just think are cold, or if I see some Nike sweatpants, I love sweatpants for those of y'all who know me. So I could see them and be like, man, I need to get those. And granted, whenever I go to the store with the intention to buy something, obviously I have the money for it. But what she's saying is, even if you have the money for it, really ask yourself, like, do I really want it that bad? Let me give myself 2 weeks and then I'll come back. And if I still want it, I will get it. But that delays your purchase. And a lot of times for me, I can speak to this. Whenever I've done that, and I don't do it consciously, I've done it very subconsciously, but whenever I've done that, I'm like, they're not even as good as I thought they were. You know what I'm saying? Those shoes ain't as cold as I thought they were. Can't believe I almost bought those. Then something else might come up, something better that you didn't even know you were going to want in the future. But that delaying that gratification, for one, that's a discipline thing. Two, that gives you time to make a rational decision on if you really want to buy something or not. Because at least in my case, Nike stuff ain't cheap. And that example I just gave you actually rolls over perfectly into this next piece of advice. And this piece of advice is really dope. It actually went over my head at first. I had to reach back out to her for clarification on this. But this is some really dope advice. Listen very closely. Invest the same amount of what the item costs. So the way I think of it is this, and obviously everyone is not going to be able to afford doing this, but this is a good piece of advice when it comes to building wealth, because if you think about it like this, we all consume items at some scale. Like, you might go to Target, you might go to McDonald's, you might go to Nike. You know what I'm saying? All of those have a place in the stock market. Every single one of those I just named have a stock. So if I go to Target and I spend $200 worth of groceries, I could go buy a $200 Target stock. If I go to McDonald's and spend $10 on a meal, I could put $10 into a McDonald's stock. So I'm not going to get all into stocks, but what she's saying is, this can build that discipline, because you might think twice about buying something because you can actually put money into the stock market. And maybe you won't be able to do this every single time, because you kind of have to have disposable income, like a lot of disposable income to do this. But the way I think of this piece of advice is this. We consume stuff at a certain scale every single day, whether it's going to the grocery store. You could go to Target, Walmart. Those are examples of stock options. Microsoft, there's Apple. We consume these types of products and they all have stocks. And so the way I look at it is like this, like, I mean, you know what I'm saying? I love Nike. So wouldn't it make sense for me to have a Nike stock? I love Apple. I love Microsoft. I use them all the freaking time. Shouldn't I have a stock share in those? And you also have to think about this, and Lynn, correct me in the comments if I'm wrong, but what I get from her advice is this. Don't buy something unless you can buy two of them. And if I'm on the right track, Lynn has an excellent point. And the best way to bring that point home is this. About a week ago, I saw this interview with the Wall Street Trapper. And this guy is heavy into stocks. He's a stock expert. He has a platform where he teaches people about stocks. Really sharp dude. He knows what he's doing. And the way he explained this was, he's like, look, in our community, like specifically where he's from New Orleans. He said, in our community, we love designer clothes. Gucci, YSL, stuff like that. The way he got his community into it was saying, look, we already wearing Nikes. And this is just an example. This is just paraphrasing what he's saying. He's like, we're already wearing Nikes. We're already wearing Gucci. Why not own it? Because when you buy a share of something in a stock form, you're literally a shareholder of that. You're a partial, very small partial owner of that company. And that's what started to get people to think, like, you know what, that actually makes sense. And then that money goes up in value. But when you buy stuff, it depreciates in value. Shoes get dirty. You know what I'm saying? Purses wear out all the time. Got to keep in mind, I got a lady audience. Lynn was telling me I got to stop saying bro. She's a lady. All right. You make a good point, bro. But anyway, her last tip is build wealth accumulating assets, and that is a phenomenal tip. And I want to break that down even further, right? Because usually when people think about wealth accumulating assets, they think, oh, well, I'm going to have to spend money that I can't afford to lose. They're thinking that they got to spend money in the stock market or in real estate, and you don't, because there's a bunch of different types of assets nowadays. For example, this YouTube video you're watching right now, this entire channel you're watching right now is actually a wealth accumulating asset. And YouTube is something that you can start totally free. And I'll tell you this, every single video that I have up on my channel right now makes money. And that's really awesome to say, because every video, it could be a year ago, 2 years ago I made the video, is still making money. That's an asset. And you know, it's not just like a YouTube thing. Content as a whole is an asset. There's people making money from videos that they put on IGTV, Facebook. They're putting out pictures and content that are sponsored by like Microsoft and all these other big companies. Per every like they get, per every view that they get, or whatever the metric is for whatever platform, they're getting money for that. That is an asset. And if you also follow Lynn's advice to invest, then yeah, like you could put a little money here and there in the stock market. And if you don't have money like that, that's cool. You could start a Stash account or an Acorns account and start with $5. And you don't have to buy a full share at a time. You can buy partial shares. And when you buy partial shares, you can still get the benefits that having a full share would have in terms of going up in value. So that was Lynn's advice right there, and I thought it was really dope. And I know she had a really long message that she sent me, but she just spent the rest of that telling me how great I am, you know what I'm saying? And I appreciate that humbly, you know what I'm talking about. Nah, I'm just kidding. She actually spent the rest of that conversation telling me, and stop calling me bro, I am a lady. You have ladies watching this channel. So ladies and bros, give a round of applause. That was some dope advice. So we have a few from the community tab that I just wanted to go over real quick. So Emily said, get direct deposit of a portion of your paycheck to go into your savings account. You won't even notice the deduction and it will build your savings account. And that's 100% true. It really is. And I think it's a method that a lot of people sleep on, because they feel like, you know, well, I'll remember to put that $200 into my savings account. But then you'll do it for like a month or two and then you'll forget. And I've done it. So the best way to do it is to just simply automate it like she's saying. That's perfect advice right there. And the thing is, once things are automated, you don't miss that money. It's just like your taxes. They get taken out automatically, so you don't even miss that. But if you had it all along, you would. And I don't know if it's just like a time-consuming thing, but I've talked to people about this one-on-one and everything, and you know, they feel like it has to be all on discipline. Like, no, you can literally just automate everything. You can automate, you know, your paychecks to go straight, some of it going straight into your savings account, and you can be fine. So thank you, Emily. That's some good advice. And we have Triple X, interesting name, by the way. So Triple X says, my advice is to have multiple accounts and use them categorically. Nice word. Spread it out and set categories that gives each account a purpose of use. And that is the game right there. And that right there, that is what you should do. That's why I talk about the Capital app so much. But this video ain't about the Capital app. This is about what my audience has to say. And you can't go wrong with this advice, because if you separate your accounts categorically and you name them, that then gives every single dollar that you put into that account a purpose. And as you might have seen a couple videos ago, when I talked specifically about purpose and how saving money and lining up with purpose are two very big things, that when you combine the two, you're able to save a lot more, a lot faster. This is exactly what I mean. That's why I don't believe in having all of your money in one savings account, because it feels like, well, you don't really know what all of it's for. So if it's split up, you know exactly what every individual thing is for. And you know how important each one is compared to the other. So that's all the subscriber and viewer advice that I have to share with you today. If I didn't get to you, don't feel bad about it. Just know that I chose the advice that I found, one, extreme value in, but two, weren't as common as all the other ones. I mean, the advice that I shared in this video today, I haven't seen in a lot of other YouTube videos or channels or anything. And I also snuck in one or two pieces of common advice that I just don't see commonly followed, that I really think people should really push to do. But anyways, as the CEO of this channel, I think I owe it to you to share what my future plans are for this channel, since you guys got me to 5K. Thank you so much. So with my YouTube channel, I just really want to cast a wide net around financial literacy. So that's why you hear me talking about stocks, and I'm even talking about stuff that I'm learning myself, because I get excited when I learn about stuff, and when I feel like I'm knowledgeable about something enough, I go ahead and start sharing things with you guys. So when it comes to appreciating assets and stuff like that, I share that with you. Stocks, ETFs, you know what I'm saying, index funds, all that good stuff. But also, you know, I'm just working on a bunch of different things. So part of casting that wide net was me opening up an Asana account and putting all my ideas, just plastering them all up there on one big sheet. And one day I just sat for like 2 to 3 hours and I just created this entire list on Asana, and I really just put out like, there's got to be like 200 video ideas in this thing. And I'm going to show it to you right now on the screen. I'm not kidding. But as you're looking at my beautiful spreadsheet that I made on Asana, I also want you to be, you know, think about stuff that you want to see from me. And you can totally reach out to me personally, or you can just comment on my videos. You can say, hey, if you haven't already, make a video about this, or I'd like to see a video about this, because I don't always know what everyone's financial struggles, or if you want to learn something more, I don't always know what exactly you want to know more about, because I could be knowledgeable in something, but I could just think that and just assume that people already know about it. And I found that out in my one-on-one conversations when I was setting those up, which I'll get some more on that in a second. But I think it would be extremely valuable if you guys would email me on my personal email, or even DMing me on Instagram. You guys can totally do that. Just follow me, you know, DM me. I'll answer. I mean, I answer all my DMs. Same thing goes for email. You know what I'm saying? It actually goes into my next point. This is what I'm super excited about announcing. I view this YouTube channel as more than just, you know, like a free hub for me to give you free information. This is also the heart of my business. And so I recently just got a Kajabi account, and I'm building my website, and through my website is where my business is going to live. So I'm opening up financial coaching, and I'm super, super excited about it. Something I'm extremely passionate about in life, like in real life I do this, is coaching people, and I've got to extend it on to the finances now. And so with that, not only am I going to have like paid coaching services, but I'm also going to have one free window of 15-minute coaching, and I'm going to open it up a couple times a week, a few hours out of the day, and I'm going to have the availability up on Calendly. So if you guys are available, if you just want to talk finances with me one-on-one for 15 minutes, you can set up a call with that. And that's going to all be on my website. And I haven't finished building the website yet, but just know all that stuff I'm talking about is coming in the next few weeks and months. And on that website, outside of just my coaching services and everything, I'm also going to have my courses. And yes, I said courses. The reason it's taken so long to put everything together that I've been talking about for the past like year now about these online courses is because there's more than one course. There's like three of them. I talked to a lot of you guys one-on-one about a month ago, and a lot of you talked about what you wanted and needed in a course, and all of you aligned, so I'm building courses on it, and I'm super excited about that. So about a month ago, I talked to you guys about what exactly you wanted and needed out of a course, and you guys have told me, and I've taken everything you said to heart. I wrote down everything. I took notes on what you guys said, and so I built courses around what you guys want and need. And there'll be more information on everything about this. I just want to give you a quick update so you can know what to look forward to when it comes to me. And also, this is the cool part that I'm really excited about. I'm about to open up a Patreon account. And on there, I'm going to host exclusive content, and you'll see the conversations that I have with people about money. You might even see some coaching calls, stuff like that. Of course, I have to ask for their consent to share that video on Patreon, but I think it's going to be dropping some good gems for you guys that are, you know, more in-depth than what you would normally get on my channel. And I think the value in that would be these 15-minute calls that I'm setting up for free a few hours out of a couple of days of a week. You know, obviously not everyone's going to be able to experience those. So you're going to be able to see what that one-on-one interaction looks like. And it'll be on Patreon. It'll be like super value-added conversations, because when I talk to people about finances, we really get into it. And it's really valuable to see, I think. And when you capture those conversations in real time, I think that is one of the most valuable ways to learn about finances. So anyways, make sure you're looking out for that stuff, because it is coming and it's going to be extremely valuable. And I just want to thank you so much for your support. And I already got people saying, all right, time for 10,000. Let's go. You got this, bro. And when I see comments like that, it means a lot, because I was just on the phone with my friend the other day, and she was like, all right, time for 50,000. Let's go. So now I have something to work towards, you know what I'm saying? So now it's like, all right, now I have to live up to these numbers, because now, you know, you guys are having those expectations and you guys are seeing me grow and you want me to grow even more. Let's get it. I'm ready for it. But anyway, that's the video for today. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Reggie Bryant, and this channel is all about personal finance and personal growth, so you can control you, control your finances, and control your life. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Stay cold.